Inkling player now.
Yeah. Xcal actually moved on earlier. I was commentating on that. Now we're gonna see him playing against Ike. Now this is a very different Ike, obviously, going into this. It's J-Prog on the other side, but we've also known what Mario can do against Ike in general. Just being complete combo food. You want to short hop, you want to nair, you want to set up your spacing, and then Mario just breaks that zone so quickly and keeps you in the air for so long.
And we talked about it, we just watched this match, us personally in fact, Wizzy and Mars, another great Ike player, Ike secondary obviously, so a little bit of a difference, but Wizzy definitely knows his way around forcing that issue. Ike has no good action in disadvantage.
Especially out of shield. Just being, having, like, right there, there's nothing he could do other than hold shield and wait to react to what Wizzy's going for, or potentially try and rush him down.
And the last thing we saw, too, was, like, a shield grab attempt. Wizzy just spot dodge and punished again.
One good thing that J-Proc has going for him, though, is that once this damage reaches this point right here where he evened it up, all he needs is maybe one more hit, and that nair to up air is going to get another kill. A kill.
Looking for it right now, 115. Gonna make it back to the ledge. Wizzy putting the pressure on. Big back air. Should be it with the flood. No, doesn't connect. There it is, bro. The forehead.
Running up. He got a read on that before, too, because he pushed him to the ledge. He opted to use a get-up attack off the tech. So it's like, all right, you're more opting to just throw out an attack if you see me approach. And Wizzy has been getting so much better conditioning and reading people when they do that.
Yep.
Also, that flood, like you said, like even off, even in center stage, just being able to back off Ike and like, you know what, I don't like your approach game right now. I want you to get frustrated, and I'm gonna reset this.
Yeah, it's pretty low risk, honestly. Speaking of low risk, eruption, not one move I would consider low risk. They're going for another one as well.
Yeah, if you're not near the ledge, they're not getting a punish, potentially a bear on that. That could have gotten him a stock.
Really good weight though from JT. I like that.
Like the fact that, you know, even though in the deficit right now, he's not trying to overcommit, because all he needs to do, well, actually, now he's at a percent range now, but all he needs is one straight hitbox, and he can take the stock.
Dark Wizzy. Oh, that air dodge is not good, but Wizzy missed the follow-up grab back to neutral here, down to great opener.
Yeah, JT aiming for a tomahawk into up tilt there to try and anti-air Wizzy, but Wizzy just broke the zone just fast enough. Like, if you could prevent Ike from actually getting his footing before he gets started, oh my god, the commitment level, and that you deserve that punish. Yeah. But that, you know, if he decided to get up and just roll on, it would have been good for Wizzy.
I'm saying it almost worked. Oh my god, it's even. Two nairs, 13.7. All right.
One of the things Wizzy actually needs to be careful of, because he's getting a little bit hit by a few more of these nairs, because it gets caught at the ledge with a nair to up B, he could just even this back out.
Very true. I like that route. Get back in the stage from JT, avoiding the flood problems. Big back throw or forward throw here.
I like it. Recovering low, opting to just be careful, but he's still consistently going for aggressive options off the ledge. And Wizzy, he's actually not getting these quick draws still.
Bro!
I like it. Just throw out more quick draws. He's, you know, all right, Wizzy's playing back. You know, blitz him a little bit, throw him off, and now a nair to up air is that could potentially take the lead.
He should have charged it, bro. He should have just, like, held on. Oh, okay. A little bit of a clank here. Is anybody's stock right now? No.
Yeah, this is one of those times where it's like, all right, I want to play respectful, but also playing too respectful just caused Wizzy to take so much damage. JT bringing it back.
All right, 105 on Wizzy. A big hit will probably still do it. Forward are going to knock him off. Another forward are going to knock him near the blast zone and not going to connect. Oh, wow. Caught him with that bad DI on the up tilt. I wasn't ready for it.
Yeah, no, catch him on the tech, on the read, and like that was, again, like a relatively bad DI, went straight to the top. I mean, it is a very strong move, but now we're back to a dead even percent. Well, not dead even, but much better.
Dangerous air dodge from Wizzy, but he's still looking good. Jab for the extended.
And trying to keep him in the corner, but JT just walling his way back in with that huge hitbox he's got.
Big trade for JT. Looking not too bad. Oh my god, the back hit! Wizzy living!
Wizzy got away with that one. That is never where you want to go. That is such a strong move, regardless of being at like 70%.
No!
just neutral get up, and he's not going to get hit by nair to up air either. He DI'd out.
Yep. Oh, that dash tag was so bold, but the up smash not fast enough. And Wizzy, the down smash. Wizzy, he wants it. And Wizzy.
And he had to go low because he air dodged and didn't get the ledge.
Yep.
That ended up costing him. That was a really good comeback, though, from JT.
It really was. But that unfortunate air dodge looked like he just wanted to air dodge down, maybe to the ledge or to the ground. And then once he missed the ledge, it was over.
Yeah, that's one of the unfortunate things when it comes to the Aether boys. Like, either Crom or Ike, the moment that you air dodge past that ledge, you have full commitment. That's the only thing you can do. Your air dodge is not that good to get you back.
Yep.
And Flood is gonna take it most of the time. There are times where it might miss and, you know, you can snap that ledge. Luckily for Wizzy, it did not.
Well, interesting. You know, as experienced as Wizzy is in the matchup, you know, we talked about it. Still look like anyone's game.
Mm-hmm. That's the scary part about Ike. It's like Ike has the great release, great equalizer at all times. The fact that almost every hitbox he has is a kill move.
Right.
So you have to respect him the moment that he gets to like 80-some-odd percent.
Alright, and then Wizzy, with the unconventional opening to say at least, just going for the Flood right away. Trying to slow down the pace a little bit.
I like the fact that JT also, instead of reserving to just the nair's on approach to like try and keep it safe, he's doing a lot of fadeaway fares too. Like that was always the problem when it came to Mario against Marth in the prior game, having to deal with that spacing.
Right.
Now JT's kind of doing that only with like.
All right, nice combo here from Wizzy. 81% stuck at the ledge. Oh, nice. I love. Waited till the last possible minute, but didn't last much longer.
That was the same. That's that download from the prior game. JT is consistently getting up with get-up attack and, you know, rising aerials of some sort.
Right.
That's a bad spot. Like, Wizzy just walked away and punished him for it.
True. Honestly, the last stock, Wizzy missed the forward smash punish on what was a regular get-up just because of mistiming, not because of a missed read or anything. So definitely seeing a lot of regular get-ups from JT. To be fair, Ike doesn't have a lot of action at the ledge either. So.
Yeah, you know, drop down up B or rising aerials, that's one thing or another. And he does have good aerial drift, but Mario's so good at getting that anti-air and also racking up big combo damage.
Oh, that's it.
Okay. I thought he was going to let it rip with the forward air too, but he was not close enough. Wizzy was already in place to catch that quick draw too. Yep. This is a... See, yeah, Wizzy's definitely getting a bit more footing here.
Oh,
oh, he doesn't get the up air. That would have potentially gotten him the stock.
Oh, all right. Quick draw. Jump quick draw from the ledge. Not something we've seen. Looks like Wizzy wasn't ready for it, but you got to save those because Wizzy's not going to get hit by that again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and if it hits your shield, that's a free punish. So Yep. It is a good option to pull out every once in a while just to throw off your opponent, but the cross-up dash attack is going to land him in a punish situation, and now Wizzy with a large lead.
It's so funny, man. Like, crossing up Mario is like the opposite of what you want.
Yeah.
I'd much rather just get grabbed or jabbed instead. Like, nope, up smash.
Yeah, there's so many characters with bad out-of-shield options to deal with cross-ups. Mario definitely blessed with many be able to deal with that. Up smash, back air, down air, doesn't really matter.
Oh.
Oh, dear.
Yep. Well, there it is,
throw that handshake out there.
I've seen enough Dark Wizzy games. That's why I said that, oh, that's it on that last stock, is because I'm used to seeing stuff like that, you know?
Yeah, my excitement went from to, well, because.
Right about here.
Yeah,
like,
right
the
there. It's like, yeah, that's
there.
It.
Yep. There it is.
Catch the dome piece. Wizzy has gotten so good at consistent. Could you? Why are you torturing me like that?
Why does his hand get so big? For?
Let Ike leave Ike alone.
Running back.
Stop.
There it is. Up there, Porter.
All right, looks like Devin ain't making it past his birthday.
The last
throw some shots at me over here.
Sorry.
Yeah.
But, oh, all right. Well, listen, we got good thing we all drove several states over.